Hello there, Mark here. Welcome to Recent Final Finds number 79. I'm going to start with some recent spins, some albums I've been playing over the last couple of weeks. John Cale, Sabotage Live. This was recorded at CBGB in 1979. John was very much addicted to drugs at this point in his life. And this is a very, foreboding album, and its lyrics and its content. It speaks of war. Very powerful. Excellent band. Mark Aaron's guitar playing is excellent. It really stands out. And what they lack in finesse, they more than make up in feeling. You have Mercenaries, Ready for War, 7 minutes and 33 seconds of what I consider one of John's best compositions. Then you have the epic Captain Hook, Sabotage. John is just screaming like a madman over a very robotic drum beat. And then you have Coral, which is probably my favorite track. 20 years ago, it probably would have been my least favorite track. But at this time in my life, I do prefer John's, more classical-based compositions. And the lyrical content of that song is beautiful. So I highly recommend this album. It's on Spy Records. Featured this album in a recent video. I was really impressed by the quality of this release. I have not listened to No Doubt in years. I don't know why. I love this band. I have all of their original albums. Just brought back so many great memories. Paid $11 for it. The original price was $35, which I think is a lot of money to pay for a greatest hits collection. But the vinyl, it's an excellent pressing. Both discs, and with new releases, that very often that is not the case. The sound quality is spectacular. It came with a very nice booklet with some great photographs of the band, some really nice essays. At least they put some thought in this release. Just really impressed. Some nice studio shots, classic pictures of the band. One thing people may not like, it just came in a regular paper sleeve. So I guess you might say they could have included a padded sleeve, but well worth the $11 I paid. I picked up this excellent title a few weeks ago, Willie Nelson, Angel Eyes. I was not familiar with this title from Willie's extensive catalog. This features the excellent guitar work of Jackie King, a well-respected jazz guitarist. Dare I say, country jazz. This is a beautiful album featuring Ray Charles. Willie has always been pointed out for his excellent vocal phrasing. He's a country and western musician with a jazz musician's heart. Frank Sinatra, I even think Miles commented on how much they loved Willie's singing style. He's always kind of skirting around the beat. This is a beautiful recording. Really enjoyed this one. You enjoyed the needle drop. We'll continue with some recent vinyl finds. I was talking to a friend a couple weeks ago. We were discussing our favorite live albums. This title came up. I've had this on CD for years. I picked up this original sealed copy at my local shop a couple weeks back for $25. This is Al Green, Tokyo Live. Phenomenal. This is a much different experience than you hear on Al's studio recordings. It's very loose. It's excellent band backing him. Not that he did not have excellent players in the studio. This was recorded in 1978. He was invited to partake in the Tokyo Music Festival. His 16 competitors, all international stars, included Blondie, Kate Bush, Debbie Boone. That's kind of a stretch with her, but he won. This is a 2 LP set. He covers lots of classic recordings, some extended jams. To note, I Feel Good, Love and Happiness. And then you have the Al Green ballads, God Bless Our Home, Dream, For the Good Times, Kris Kristofferson composition, Let's Stay Together, Tired of Being Alone. Just phenomenal. This album disappointed on so many levels. I was not familiar with this gentleman's, legal battles at the time of purchase. It's really disappointing to hear how his life has progressed. But I thought I got a great buy on this album. It was new. This is Puff Daddy and the Family, No Way Out. This was $13.99. One of my favorite albums from back in the day. So I cracked this bad boy open. And I guess you could say I doubled my pain, because no quality control. I have two C and D sides of the album. So, unfortunately, I bought this from a record store that is not really around the corner. I'm not even going to make the effort to return it. Someday I may get lucky and see a used copy in a shop and just combine the two. But that was a disappointment. And to add insult to injury, the record is not totally flat. Does this album scream 1980s, early 1980s? Come on. Malcolm McLaren. Some great tracks on this one. Obviously, you know I love my time strips. Some Keith Haring art on the back. Very cool. Happy to pick this one up. This is the most recent expanded pressing of the Talking Heads' Stop Making Sense. The first pressing sold out. I think the second pressing is pretty much sold out. I think this is hard to find at this point. They've included a few extra songs that were not on the initial release. It's one of my, if not my favorite, concert films from the 80s. I bought the rest of the albums at flea markets over the summer. Paid $4 for this copy of Talking Book. Yes, it has a marker on the cover, but the vinyl is in excellent condition. This is the Braille jacket. So you have little message from Stevie and Braille on the inside as well. What is my favorite Stevie Wonder album? Well, I go back and forth between Talking Book and Songs in the Key of Life. I just can't make that distinction. They're both perfect from beginning to end. Paid a dollar for this one. The cover is pristine. In Dreams, of course, the big O, Roy Orbison, and this is on the Monument label. This is a French pressing of this beautiful Julie London album from 1984. Make Love to Me with Russ Garcia and his orchestra. Beautiful sounding release. This was $4 as well. The vinyl is flawless. Just a beautiful picture of Julie. Kind of matches her sultry vocal style. This is $4 as well. Just pristine. This is Yes. 90125. It's in the shrink. It is a cutout. This was probably my flea market find of the summer. This is by Joe Farrell. Canned Funk. If you like jazz funk, this belongs in your collection. First of all, look at that beautiful cover. This is pristine. I paid $4 for this album. Sells for a lot more. The vinyl is flawless. It's the beautiful original inner as well. Just everything's perfect about this recording. This is often used as an audiophile reference recording. The sound quality is spectacular. And man, this is a funky release. Of course, the title track. And these are extended jams. Animal, 9 minutes and 55 seconds. Spoken Silence. This is phenomenal. Who do you have playing here? Joe Beck on guitar. Jim Madison on drums. Just spectacular. Highly recommend this album. This was also $4. This is Still Sealed, the Paul Desmond Quartet. This was $4 as well. Memphis Horns. This is a mono promo copy. Beautiful white label. And you've heard these cats on so many classic soul R&B recordings from Stax, Atlantic. This is filled with some great songs. You have Soul Man, Woolly Bully, 1 Mile High, Cherry Tree. Really excellent album. I've been buying upgraded copies of 80s albums that I've had in my collection since my teenage years. They have lots of miles on the odometer, and I just feel that it's time to upgrade the copy that I have. And this is titled by Climax, Meeting in the Ladies Room. And this has some excellent 80s R&B on it. The Men All Pause, that was a single taken off of the album, along with the title track. I Betcha, I just really love this album. Again, lots of great memories attached to this recording. And that was $4 as well. And then this title that I already own, this was $4. I'm gonna give this to a friend. This is the second release on Blue Note Records. This is by, it's a piano solo by Albert Ammons, Boogie Woogie Stomp. This was part of the Blue Note 75th series, which I believe the recordings were cut from digital, which is fine. This has a $16.99 price tag on, which seems like a lot of money for just a 12-inch single. If your life is a long road, come undone. I think we'll stop here. I hope you enjoyed the video. Take care.